welcome to my channel. This video, I'm going to educate you about suicide. This is a mental health topic. Okay, let's start. Okay, so suicide is a final result of self-destructive behavior. Suicide behavior includes the following. Suicide behavior includes the following. Suicide gestures, parasuicide, also known as suicide attempts, and complete suicide. Suicide gestures, these are suicide plans and actions that appear likely to be fatal. So they are suicide plans and actions that appear likely to be fatal. And the parasuicide, also known as the suicide attempts, these are suicide actions that are intended to be fatal, but they do not succeed. So in this, a person is trying to commit suicide, but they do not succeed. And then we have complete suicide. Complete suicide, this is simply suicide that results in death. So we're looking at suicide gestures. Suicide gestures, you're just looking at a person having suicide plans, and they are showing actions, and those actions, they are appearing to be fatal. And then the parasuicide, the person, they carry on with their suicide plans. However, they fail to succeed, and then with a complete suicide, they actually succeed and they end up dying. Now, some people who attempt suicide may be discovered early and be saved. Some who attempt are ambivalent about dying, and so the attempt may fail because it is a plea for help combined with a strong wish to live. However, all suicide thoughts and behaviors, whether gestures or attempts, should be taken seriously. They should be taken seriously. So some people try to attempt suicide because it's more like a cry for help, so that you can help them. At the end of the day, they still have a strong wish to live. So you need to take all these seriously, whether it's a gesture or it is an attempt. Now, let's look at the causes of suicide. Some things that can lead a person to commit suicide. One of those things is mental disorders, mostly which result from depression and substance abuse. And you're going to find that over 50% of suicide cases, you're going to find that those people, they are usually depressed. Those who commit suicide, or those who attempt to commit suicide. So mental disorders is one of the causes for someone to commit suicide. Social factor is another cause. Social factor can be in the form of disappointment, loss, or lack of social support. These things that I've mentioned under the social factor can lead a person to have to start thinking of committing suicide. Personality disorders such as impulsiveness and aggressions. These personality disorders, they are very common with people who attempt suicide. Another cause of suicide is chronic physical illnesses. So on this one, you can look at, for example, an incurable physical illness. Because the person is thinking to say, even if I keep on living, there is no point, I'll be just suffering, so better I end my life. So under chronic physical illness, those are the things that we can look at, such as an incurable physical illness. So now look at these factors that I've given you: mental disorders, social factors, personality disorders, and chronic physical illness, as those things that can lead a person to commit suicide. Let's look at the methods that are commonly used when someone wants to commit suicide. Drug overdose, or taking poisonous chemicals, gunshots, jumping from a tall building, strangulation with rope, belt, or a string. These are the commonly used methods of suicide. So now, how can we prevent these? How can we prevent people from suicide? One of those things is to take any threat or suicide act seriously. And the following interventions that I'm going to give you are what you're supposed to act on as you're trying to prevent suicide. One of the interventions is suicide hotline. If a person is threatening to commit suicide and they are in a crisis and you feel it's an emergency, you should call the hotline, suicide hotline. Okay. Another intervention is try to establish a relationship with a suicidal person. For example, reminding him or her about their identity repeatedly. So you're reminding this person, you're trying to establish a relationship with this person who's trying to commit suicide by calling out their name. Okay? So you're reminding them of their identity as you are calling their name over and over. Then offer the other constructive help for the person that brought the crisis and encourage him to take positive action to resolve it. Then remind the person that he has a family and friends who care and want to help. You should also facilitate emergency face-to-face professional help. So you're counseling this person under the face-to-face professional help. Now, if the person alerts you of his suicide intentions, for example, if he says he's about to commit suicide, keep discussing with them and then inform someone else to call the helpline, okay, or the hotline, for example, to call the police until the help team arrives. So you need to keep this person in a conversation as the other person is calling the hotline. Now, how do you treat those people who attempt suicide? Treatment of those people who attempt suicide, if it is an overdose, you need to try to remove as much of the drug as possible from the system. Okay, so you remove the drug and then you should monitor the vital signs and treat the symptoms to keep the patient or the person alive. Administer an antidote if known. Even if the patient may be well and discharged, they are often hospitalized for psychiatric assessment and treatment. Discharge will be determined by resolution of their suicide-inducing problem. The risk of another attempt is very high unless the problem is resolved. So now, what am I trying to tell you? What I'm trying to tell you is that a complete suicide has a powerful emotional impact on all those involved. The family, friends, and caregivers may feel guilty, shame, and remorse at having failed to prevent the suicide. They may as well feel angry towards the person. A suicide attempt has a similar impact. Though there is an opportunity for those close to the patient to resolve their feelings by responding to the person's cry for help. Okay, so this is where we're going to end with this topic. But one thing that you should remember is that suicide is a final result of self-destructive behavior. And there are three types of suicide: suicide gestures, past suicide, and complete suicide. Okay, the gestures, the person is just informing you of their plans, and they have these particular actions that appear as if they want to commit suicide. And then when you're looking at the past suicide, it means it is a suicide attempt. This person has attempted to commit suicide and they failed. With a complete suicide, the person is already dead. So make sure that, or you put in place those interventions that I've given you in saving a person who is trying to commit suicide, by making sure that you call the hotlines, e.g. the police, so that they can go and help. You try to establish a relationship with the person trying to commit suicide, and at the same time you can facilitate an emergency face-to-face professional help. Okay, that's it with this video. Make sure that you subscribe to my channel.